When I was 6 years old, I fell into the Arno. I soon found myself drifting down and into darkness. Certain my life was at an end. Instead, I woke to the sound of my mother weeping. At her side stood a stranger, soaking and smiling at me. My mother explained that he had saved me. And so began a long and prosperous relationship between two families. Yours and mine. I am sorry I could not save your father and brothers.
You have nothing to apologize for. I believe Jacopo de Pazzi played a part in their deaths. The attack on you as well. I need to find him.
That coward fled before we could arrest him.
Have you any leads?
No. They've hidden themselves well.
They?
Jacopo was not the only conspirator to escape.
If they work with Jacopo, they were surely involved in the plot against my family as well. Give me their names.
Antonio Maffei. Archbishop Francesco Salviati, Stefano da Bagnone, and Bernardo Baroncelli.
Bene. I will go and see my uncle. He has men stationed in the countryside.
Wait. Before you go.
A codex page.
I took it from the files of Francesco de Pazzi, seeing as he clearly no longer needs it. I've always had an interest in things of antiquity. As did your father.
It is meaningful to me as well.
Then consider it a gift. Che il Signore ci protegga.
Jacopo de Pazzi, the money. This guy was the head of the Pazzi family, and he ran their banking business. An associate of Lorenzo de' Medici, he had nothing against him personally. So he hired four Templar hitmen to take care of the situation for him. Bernardo di Bandino Baroncelli. Brought up to hate the Medici family for the exile of his cousins, Baroncelli ran the numbers in the Pazzi bank by day and murdered for the Templars at night. It was Baroncelli who delivered the first blow. Stefano de Bagnone. Known for his cruelty, Bagnone was trained in Rome as a Templar butcher. It was Bagnone who stabbed Lorenzo de' Medici in the back. Antonio Maffei. Witness to the sacking of Volterra by Florentine mercenaries, Maffei blamed Lorenzo. He joined the Templars to seek revenge. It was Maffei who slashed Lorenzo's neck. Archbishop Francesco Salviati. Convinced he would be the next Archbishop of Florence, Salviati was enraged when Lorenzo stood in his way. But the Templars were there to heal his wounds. It was Salviati who marched their troops into the city.
Thank you. The biannual congress has been postponed due to the legal concerns now responsible for public. It shall be held sometime after.
Get out of your way.
Guardate che meraviglia quest'agnello!
have joined my workshop. We are offering you some of the most glorious pieces at the best values.
Salute a voi. Salve.
The citizens of Pisa, salute. I've held a mass demonstration. Folios of Bologna. Important defaults suffer.
Assassino, get him!
Stop it!
Of the great assassino.
Defile the dead.
Madness. Walk away.
Blessed Virgin, preserve us all.
What? That's your fault. Oh, no. I should be through sounds of hell. Hard at work.
Vile man! How dare you rob the dead?
How dare you defile the dead?
One more sent to the Lord, and you'll find peace in the hereafter.
Oh, blood. Dear Lord, what beasts you have killed.
By all that is holy, hear me well.
We run an honest business, no fancy.
Come, don't be shy. I only aim to heal.
Madre Santa, preserve me.
You won't get away!
So, how would you like to go?
The crow?
Why? Never mind. Don't want to know.
Come, come, don't be shy.
I've quite a few different accessories too. Things you may not know you need.
Break something.
All who need aid are welcome.
The best, and you should be well recovered, friends.